Serving is all about strategy. A good server disrupts the offense with power and finesse and keeps the serve receive guessing and adjusting. So why don't we take the same approach with serve receive? The best passers don't just get the ball to target. They also make servers adjust and think. We're gonna go through our four serve receive golden rules. 1, adjust. 2, never get aced in the seams. 3, everyone passes. And 4, no overpasses. First, let's talk adjusting. Too often, we let the server move us around and we get caught being stagnant in our base and having to react, allowing the server to go on runs. Players that are newer to the game go to a spot on the court. Instead, we want to observe server tendencies and adjust our serve receive accordingly. If a server keeps going short, there's no need for us to stand in the same spot. Let's move up and force the server to do something else. If they fail to adjust, it's a win for us. If they serve deep and short and keep mixing it up, okay, they're a great server. But don't just let the server do their favorite serve without putting pressure on them. At the highest levels of the game, we will shift to zone 1 or 5, depending on the server's tendencies. Giving them a different look will force them to think. And in my experience, the servers that have to think are those that are the most inefficient. So if we're adjusting and playing the odds that a server will serve here or there, then we can't think of each ball as equal. This brings us to our second golden rule, never get aced in the seams. Aces down the line and in deep corners are really hard balls to serve, meaning a lot of players aren't great at serving those spots, and even those that are have less probability of getting it in the court because they're aiming for a small area on the court. So if the most hit shots are towards the center of the court, why would we set up in a base position that gives equal importance to the really hard to hit line serves and the most probable inner court serve? Position yourself to handle the most likely shots. Our third golden rule is everyone passes. If the three serve receivers are taking up the 900 square feet for themselves, it will get overwhelming for them. So middles and right sides, be a part of serve receive. Everyone should be in serve receive to clog up more of the court. If the ball trickles off the net, have a middle take it. If they're short serving, have the right side take it with their hands. We're not saying they should be jumping in the way of the passers, but they should be aware and ready so we can alleviate the pressure on our serve receivers. Last but not least, no overpasses. As the setter releases to their target, we don't want to be aiming to that final location. Law of averages says that for every ball that hits that setter target, there'll be more in this general area. So if we keep aiming for the target, a certain percentage will be over the net. Instead, high-level pro and national teams are aiming towards off the net. Aiming to 6 and 7 feet off the net allows for the average pass to still be on our side. We can still run an offense if it gets to 10 feet, and if it's at the other end, it's a perfect pass. The setter's physical location shouldn't dictate where we pass. So if it's an easy free ball, we should aim here. A serve receive ball here, and a bond serve from Logan Tom, we should aim here. All will give us the best probability of running an offense with no overpasses. So to recap our four golden rules. 1, adjust. Don't get caught in one place over and over. This gives the server a huge advantage. 2, each ball is not equal. Value the balls in the seams and in the server's tendencies more than a fluke ace down the line or tape ace. 3, everyone should be in serve receive. Passers, right sides, middles, and setters should be preventing this ball from landing on the floor. 4, no overpasses. Keep the ball and run an offense.